Hello, my dear ones. Welcome to our seventh day in Orlando, Florida. We're going to the convention right now. It's the second official day of the convention. I hope that it's interesting. We have all the day very interesting lectures. So let's go and see.
Actually, here. I had to show you this with the star. I don't know, see. There, the back cars. Muslims, they take you on the, they pick you up from the airport. Let's go to the convention. This is the convention center in the
What about everybody in the back? Can you hear me now? Okay, well, good morning. How's everybody doing? I'm David Bulmer, and I'm the Four Life Chief Scientific Officer, and I'm really excited for this session here. Why are you here? Why did you come to this workshop? Right? Nobody else has transfer factor like Four Life, and so you're here to learn about that, because when you go out and you talk and you spread the word about Four Life and transfer factor, we're going to learn about the immune system. Dr. Tori Parker is going to come up and tell us everything you need to know about the immune system. In part two, Dr. Brent Vaughn is going to come up and tell us about the history, the discovery of transfer factor. Way many, many years ago is when transfer factors were discovered, and Dr. Vaughn is going to talk to us about that. And then I'm going to get back up and I'm going to tell us, how does Four Life get their transfer factor? Why is it different? How do we study it? How do we characterize it? And then after that, part four, Dr. Paula Brock is going to come up and tell us, how does transfer factor work, right? Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Does that sound like a good agenda?
Yeah.
Okay. And then after that, this is the fun part. We are going to graduate, right? It's like you're at college, right? So on your chair, you should have a certificate, right? That's like your diploma, right? And on that, with that diploma is what? What's with that diploma? There's a pen. And so that pen is going to be like your cap. And so at the end, we're going to graduate. You're going to put the pin on, right? You're going to put that pin on. And then what I want you to do is I want you to take a selfie of that pin, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Dr. Tori Parker.
Good morning, everyone. I heard a lot of excitement from Dr. Bulmer this morning. Are you guys ready to begin our session today?
Yes!
Our discussion today.
Appreciate it.
All right. What is the immune system? It can be defined in very simple terms. First, it takes care of anything that it tries to keep anything out of your body that shouldn't be in it. So what are some of the ways that we do that? We have skin, right? We can cough, we can sneeze, we can get things out of the body and keep them from getting in. So that's the first basic part of the immune system. And the second way that we think about it is anything that does get in, we have really powerful ways of taking care of that and helping our body recover and get well again after something does get inside of our bodies. So does everyone understand the basics of the immune system? You know what it is now? Are you with me? Important aspects of immunity found within our bowels, our intestines, in the gut part of your body. All right, and the last one, this one's, you think about some of the large bones, like in your leg. This is where you create some of your immune cells. It's right in the bone marrow, down in the bottom, inside of the bones. And that's where some of our cells we're gonna talk about in a minute are created. All right, does everyone know where your immune system organs are located now? Can you raise your hand? Everybody got it? Okay, should we do it really quick? Okay, we're gonna play a game, ready? Everybody, point to your thymus. Okay, point to your adenoids. Oh, you were a little slower that time. Okay, point to your bone marrow. Good, okay. Point to your tonsils. Back of your throat. Everybody got your tonsils? Okay, here's a trick question. Point to your lymph nodes. Everywhere. I've got lymph nodes all over. You've You've got lymph nodes everywhere. Good job. 70% of your immune system is found in your digestive system. Okay, everybody repeat that after me. 70%
of the immune
Ready?
System is in the digestive
70%. Two main tasks. First of all, as you saw in the beginning, they have to get rid of things that are foreign. They take care of invaders, they take care of bacteria, viruses, and other toxins that we might be exposed to. And the second one, which is also equally important, the immune system takes care of our own bodies. Sometimes something goes wrong in one of our cells. And if something goes wrong in that cell, the body has ways of recognizing that, helping get rid of that cell, and then cleaning up the leftovers, and then a new cell can replace it and heal it. So on the top, you see the neutrophil.
Neutrophil,
good.
Neutrophil.
Okay. Second one to the right, eosinophil.
Eosinophil.
Good. Eosinophil.
Eosinophil.
Okay. Next one down, basophil.
Basophil.
Good. Basophil.
Basophil.
Okay. Monocyte.
Monocyte.
Good. Natural killer cell.
Natural killer cell.
And macrophage.
Macrophage.
Okay. Everybody got those?
Yeah.
Thank you. Good to hear you repeating them. That's great. Neutrophils are the emergency response team. They're the ambulance. They're the first to arrive to that cut. And they're going to come in and they're going to immediately start attacking bacteria that may have been on your vegetables or on your knife or on your finger that now are inside your finger. And they're going to start eating up those damaging things. And there's a lot of these neutrophils in your blood. See, 50 to 70%. And so they get there quickly. They're the first to arrive. They're the emergency medical responders. Now, shortly after the emergency begins to occur, we also begin to need to control the damage at the site. Fire truck comes in and makes sure that there's no fires. They immediately kind of start off the allergic response, the inflammatory responses. You can think of inflammation sometimes like a fire, helps you remember it. And so this one is a smaller circulating, only 2 to 4%, but it begins to kind of block the area, keep other cars from getting into an accident and making sure there aren't any fires in the area. Third, we have the basophil. This one comes along, and normally, you know, when you cut your finger, your blood will start to clot, and then it gets kind of hard, and the basophil comes along and starts to secrete fluid and help you to keep the blood from clotting too quickly so that your full immune response can get there and other cells have a place to work. They keep the fluid there to work. So I think of this as like the police that come along shortly thereafter. The police come in and they put their police tape around and they cordon off the area and they let the detectives come in and investigate the accident. Make sure that there's plenty of room for the investigator to come in and to do their job. So this in the body means serotonin, histamine inducing inflammation, some swelling, some redness to help your body recover. Now, along the way, floating around in your cells, you have these cells called monocytes. These are floating around in the blood looking for an opportunity to help. So the monocyte is going to discover, as it floats around, that you've got a cut finger. It's going to go into that space, and it's going to then change into the next cell that we have right here, which is called the macrophage. So the macrophage is like your victim's advocate. There's someone that comes in and they help out the folks that were involved in the accident. They make sure they're okay, help them with their recovery, and they stay. The macrophage will stay in the area, making sure that any bacteria or dead cells or injured cells from your knife cut get cleaned up, removed, making room for the skin to heal so that you can recover and have a normal finger again. So that's the macrophage's job. Comes in and cleans up and sticks around until everything's all taken care of. All right, and our last cell, I think of the natural killer cell, at least in our example. It does many things, but one of the things it does is it's a great communicator. So the natural killer cell can help us with our understanding of what's going on around. It calls in, sends out what are called cytokines, communication signals to other cells. It helps clean things up, helps respond to the threats. It kind of has a job, does lots of different things. But one way that I thought of this is like the dispatcher, the radio control that helps bring in the fire and the ambulance and the victims' advocates and the police and helps coordinate everything and helps communicate across the board and he helps clean things up afterwards. So they're always around. All right, how did that work? Do you have a clearer understanding now of how our innate immune system responds? Can you hopefully remember cutting your finger? And the T cell. And the B cell. So we'll talk about those two now. First up is our T cell. The T cell includes the name T because it is formed in the thymus. Everybody point to your thymus. Good, you still remember. Thymus, that's where it got its name. That's where the cell matures. Now it attacks specifically. So now we're talking about, rather than a normal emergency response, this is more of a very specially trained team. This Navy SEALs or the elite special forces. They can come in and target some very specific activity very effectively. It includes several different types. We're gonna not go into those in a lot of detail, but there are helper T cells and cytotoxic T cells. Slight differences, and they have a little bit different roles, but their job is to be a very specific response to something that you may have seen before, which is why you don't get the same illness more than once in a time because of your adaptive immune system. So one way to think about T cells and how they do this job, every cell in your body has markers on the surface of its cell. Likewise, bacteria, viruses, others also have a very specific, unique shape, specific molecules on the surface of them that allow us to tell, is this me or is this something else that should not be here? So if it's you, it's called a self receptor you see on the right. And it bumps up against a cell and says, yep, that's part of me. Yep, that's part of me. Yep, that's part of me. Well, wait a minute, what are you doing here? And that is not part of me. You are not supposed to be here. So we need now to build a response and do something about it. So that is the primary principle of T cell self-recognition. Now the B cell, part of our delayed or adaptive immune system, gets its name from the bone marrow. Where's your bone marrow? Big bones, right? You have bones in your legs, lots of places. Bone marrow is where B cells mature. So they're produced by antibodies. They produce antibodies, I mean, and they send these antibodies out around the body looking to bind up to things that are not supposed to be there. One of their main roles is part of our memory. Remember we talk about recognize, respond, and remember. Remembering health threats is one of the roles that the B cell has in our immune system. And a way to remember this is to think of it like a lock and a key. So every time a B cell produces an antibody, it's a very specific key that only fits in one door. And so as an antibody is produced, it will only recognize and bind to a specific invader or one very specific type of something that should not be there. And whenever it recognizes that something's there that shouldn't be, it very quickly starts producing millions and millions of antibodies to allow your body to respond to that threat. And now we're going to take and put it all together. While the innate immune system and the adaptive immune system work independently and have their own roles, they also talk to each other. So the important thing to remember here that this gets even more complicated than this. If you've ever seen immune graphs and charts, they're missing.
Así les tomé una semana o les tomé un mes para publicar 15 veces. Eso es lo que tienen que seguir. 10 de sus 15 publicaciones son sus publicaciones de nicho. Comparten publicaciones de alto valor para crecer sus seguidores. Y acuérdense, aquí es cuando María respondió las tres preguntas claves, ¿verdad? ¿Cuáles son tus hobbies? ¿Cuál es tu experiencia? ¿Y cuáles son historias que tú puedes compartir con otras personas? Aquí es cuando ella decidió elegir cocina saludable como su nicho. 4 de las 15 publicaciones son publicaciones de atracción. Aquí es cuando desarrollas curiosidad y conectas tu estilo de vida con For Life. Aquí es cuando María hablaba acerca de compartir recetas saludables, ¿verdad? Pero no, y hablaba acerca de la oportunidad de poder viajar y trabajar desde su teléfono, pero nada más. Y luego una de tus 15 publicaciones es tu publicación de poder. Aquí es cuando invitas a las personas a conectarse contigo directamente. Y aquí es cuando María lo dejó todo allá afuera y dijo, miren, esto es lo que yo estoy haciendo, sin mencionar el nombre de For Life, ¿verdad? Pero habla acerca de la oportunidad que ella ha tenido y de los cambios que ella ha tenido en su vida e invita a que las personas se conecten directamente con ellas.
I'm switching the rooms of the convention center because I really don't find interesting the last lecture for the builder bonus. So we will go and join another conference.
Especially us here, we are all grown up with Instagram and Facebook, and the destruction is so big. So who of you has ever scrolled through Instagram or Facebook for maybe a minute and then thought, agree? So how many of you? All of us. Okay, and that's very, very dangerous. And because if we keep doing this, we will not solve the problem with our fear. So therefore, set yourself a goal on a daily basis. How many people do you want to add? How many people do you want to speak to? And then make the, find, for example, an accountability buddy where you send every Friday your statistics. And you're going to speak to each other and say, okay, this week I have 60 new contacts. From the 60 contacts, I don't know, I have 30 conversations. From the 30 conversations, I have now in the US, everybody of you can really do it. And I want to encourage you, keep on going and use social media.
And that's a good way for them to see that you really mean that you will help them in the business and that you want the best results for them, yeah? I don't wanna talk much more. I think we are having an amazing convention. I wanna thank all of the people that were here. I wanna thank Sebastian and Dana for organizing this event.
Obligatorio levantarse. Y para eso, obligatorio levántate. falta la fe tuya, falta ese poder de imaginación tuyo, que también tú dices, por ejemplo, como yo le estaba diciendo a un líder.
Misión de vida, Social Economic Networkers. Nosotros tenemos un sueño de poder vivir en un mundo mejor. Nosotros tenemos un sueño. Que más familias puedan tener una vida de abundancia y de prosperidad. Nosotros tenemos un sueño que llegará el bien en cada ser humano, independientemente de su nacionalidad, el color de su piel y su creencia. Nos podemos unir en un solo corazón al servicio de los demás. Nosotros tenemos un sueño de dejar un legado a nuestros hijos y a las futuras generaciones. Social Economic Networkers. Nosotros somos un sueño hecho realidad.
Pueden tomar asiento y poderle trazar lo que ya va a acontecer en el 2020. Alguien me preguntaba por qué estás hablando de la estrategia 2020 si estamos en el 2019. Y yo le dije, no hay tiempo para perder. Ya estamos en el 2020 hace rato. Líder, el día de hoy estamos todos aquí participando de un evento que era un evento especial de liderazgo, de líderes que lo alcanzaron y lo lograron como los diamantes en lead. Para que crees momentum en tu organización va a depender de tu visión, va a depender de cuántas ganas tú tengas. Por eso el día de hoy este plan que ya fue trazado es fundamental entender que para lograr los resultados se requiere de una estrategia. Todas las grandes generaciones sin jefe la estamos creando en este tiempo. Y la estrategia está dada, está trazada, ya la tenemos. No hay que crearla. Ah, un punto importante. Vamos a seguir un momentito para repasar esto. Vamos a ver los pasos. Los pasos. Quiero que sepas, como te dije, esto va a estar en un video la semana que viene, cortito, de 10 minutos, explicado con gráficas, para que no haya confusión. Primer paso. A mí me gusta educar con pasos. Paso 1, paso 2, paso 3, terminas el último y vuelve a qué. Que el éxito es 80 a un 90% emocional y un 20 a un 10% conocimiento.
Una vida de libertad y ayudar a uno a lograrlo. Ante ustedes, Diamante Internacional Latino, Cruz de Millón, Ángel Molina, ¡Gaby!
Esposo o esposa, a comprar la casa de tus sueños. puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar manejando el auto de tus sueños. Lo puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar ver a tus hijos graduándose de las mejores universidades porque tuviste el dinero para ayudarlos. Lo puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar tener una vida libre de deudas. Lo puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar gozar de una salud óptima. Puedes imaginar tener la libertad suficiente para hacer lo que quieras cuando quieras, porque disfrutas de libertad financiera. Lo puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar un mundo donde no existe la distancia, porque el tiempo y el dinero no es un obstáculo en tu vida. Lo puedes ver. Puedes imaginar el poder de ser parte de un movimiento socioeconómico que transformará la vida de millones de familias. Lo puedes ver. Te puedes imaginar vivir una vida plena de prosperidad y abundancia porque has encontrado una oportunidad que le ha dado propósito y significado a tu vida. ¿De qué forma puedes lograr eso que puedes imaginar? ¿Cómo lo puedes hacer realidad? Hay una compañía y un equipo que te va a guiar a lograr eso que tú puedes imaginar. La compañía For Life. El equipo Social Economic Networkers. Si Dios te dio la capacidad de imaginar, también te dio la capacidad de hacer tus sueños una realidad. Lo puedes ver.
Creyendo de que los sueños sí, sí se puede hacer una realidad. Vamos, vamos, pellizca a la persona que está a tu lado y dile los sueños. Se hace una realidad. Con esta oportunidad de For Life y Social Economic Networker, usted puede realizar tu sueño. ¿Cuánto lo ven? Sí lo veo.
Sí lo veo.
Elige. El poder de elegir es, elegir es un poder que te da libertad. Por eso hay un nivel de crecimiento emocional y mental que no mide y no tiene que ver con pobreza. Tiene que ver con decisión. Y esa decisión, por eso yo lo felicito, usted decidió estar en esta convención. Usted hizo lo que tuvo que hacer, vencer lo que hubo que vencer. Pero usted decidió, usted eligió y usted está aquí, usted está acá porque usted sabe que tiene un sueño que lo va a convertir en realidad. ¿Cuántos lo pueden ver? Doctor Nevares, ¿dónde está mi doctor? Estaba así, tenía fe. Hace 20 años yo no tenía nada, solo sueños. Y el doctor Emilio Nevares me decía: Juan, imagínate algún día comprando la casa de tu sueño. Imagínate algún día comprando el auto de tu sueño. Imagínate, Juan, algún día dándole la educación a tus hijos, la mejor educación, porque tienes el dinero. Juan, me decía, imagínate que puedas darle lo mejor a tu familia y que el tiempo y el dinero no sea un problema. Imagínate, Juan, viajando por el mundo, quedándote en los mejores hoteles. Imagínate, Juan. Juan seguía en el sótano. Imagínate, Juan, comiendo en los mejores restaurantes. Cuando Rani y yo teníamos que dividirnos un burrito, picarlo a la mitad. Imagínate, Juan. Nadie entraba en el negocio. Pero para él siempre ha sido nuestra mayor motivación. Imagínate. Lo puedes ver, Juan. Lo puedes ver. Yo me sentía como un niño cuando un padre entra a la habitación y le hace esa historia para que su hijo se duerma. Pero él nos hacía esa historia. Nosotros no teníamos nada. Pero esa historia nos dormía. Y nos dormía muy profundo, tan profundo, que empezábamos a soñar despierto. Y empezábamos a ver esas cosas que él decía que podían hacerse una realidad. Aun cuando todavía él no las tenía, era más que suficiente para decir: si yo la veo y lo creo, tú también la puedes ver y la puedes crear. El doctor Emilio Nevares continuamente. Nos andaba contando esta historia. Por eso dice que este negocio hay que hablar en historia. Porque son las historias las que nos inspiran. Son aquellas historias de Henry Ford, del coronel Sanders. Henry, cuando le dijeron, no vas a crear un auto. El coronel Sanders, cuando le dijeron, tu receta no sirve. Los hermanos Wright dijeron, están locos. Pero ellos en su imaginación veían aquellos aviones volando. Walt Disney. Pero la imaginación era tan grande que mi mentor es un hombre que ha visto esto y que hoy continúa con la misma pasión y la misma visión, empoderándote a ti y a ti y a ti, para que hagas de esa imaginación unos sueños hechos realidad. Y yo recordaba esta historia como un niño. Y cuando tú ibas a salirte del cuarto, te volteabas y me decía, Juan, díselo a él, díselo a él. Lo estás cargando mal, sí, le vas a doblar la rodilla. Dice, Juan, ¿todavía tienes sueño?
Todavía tienes sueño.
Y yo le decía, sí, papá, todavía tengo sueños. Y el papá volvía y me repetía, ¿lo puedes ver? Y yo le decía, sí, papá. Y él me decía, y lo miraba, míralo con los ojos. Y le decía, si Dios te dio la capacidad de soñar, también te dio la capacidad de hacerlo una realidad. Y volvía y me decía, Juan, ¿lo puedes ver? Y yo le decía, sí, lo veo, papá. Sí, lo veo, papá. A ver, sí, lo veo.
Much better outside, so the convention night just ended and we're going to our hotel. Yay!